From co-sleeping to sleep training, when you know it's time and you're only sharing your bed with your child because you don't know how to change this. Well, I'm going to give you 4 steps that you can take to go from co-sleeping to sleep training and get your little ones sleeping happily in their own space. So step number 1 for you from moving from co-sleeping to sleep training is a really simple but very important step, and that is to make the decision. It sounds simple, but it can be harder than it sounds. You need to be sure, you need to be ready, you need to be committed. So making that decision and making sure that both parents are on board and on the same page. It's no good if one of you wants to move on and the other doesn't and you're pulling in different directions. So making that decision together, being sure and being ready. That is your first step. Step number 2 is to have a safe and sleep conducive environment ready for your little one. That means their own safe sleep space, ideally a cot that is in their own room, that is everything needs to safety first, but the best things are going to be a nice dark room that's right temperature, that you're happy, you can hear your little one if they cry out, and so on. So this is assuming they're old enough to be in their own room, but otherwise a safe sleep space in your room is also fine, but their own set safe space. I can't say that enough. So you've made the decision, you've got a suitable sleep environment. The next thing, and this is probably the hardest piece, is you need to decide on an approach that you're going to take to responding to your little one, to putting them down, to reassuring them and helping them to settle happily in their own space. When they've been used to sleeping in with you, that closeness to you, that contact with you, to suddenly go from that to an entirely separate space of their own is quite a big jump. So there's going to be a certain amount of help required from you, reassurance, letting them know you're close by. Now, we use particular training techniques to do that, and we base that around the child's individual character, personality type, to make sure it's suited to them. And if you can figure that out, fantastic. If you need help with that, get the help, because you want to get this approach right. Otherwise, you end up going around in circles and then you feel like you've tried everything and nothing's working. There is a solution, so we want to get that right for your little one. So choosing the most suitable approach is the key step here. Once you've done that and you've chosen what you're going to do, it's time to then implement that. So you're going to put your little one into their own sleep space and you're going to use your approach to respond to them, to help them to settle, to help them adjust and get used to that new environment. The key 4th step for you is to be consistent. The last thing you want to do is chop and change. If your little one thinks they've got to sleep in their own space one moment, but then at this time they can come into bed with you, or at 5 a.m. when the going gets tough, you just go, oh, enough's enough, come in my bed. It's too confusing. So don't begin this. Don't even try to move on from co-sleeping into sleep training if you're not prepared to be consistent and stick with it. There'll be times when it feels easy, there'll be times when it might be tough. The reason is your little one will get better at settling in certain times than others. The closer they get to morning, for example, the harder it might be, and they may pick up a bit more resistance, or it might be just a bigger challenge. And you're there to help them and to help them develop and master that ability. But if you just cave, if you just give in and change and chop and move things around and change your sleep location and all kinds of things like that, it's confusing, it sets you back, and actually things are worse than before you even began. So consistency. Everybody says consistency is key, but you know, it's really understanding what that means. And it means that your little one can expect the same from you each and every time they wake, the same from you each and every time they're going to sleep. Whether mum goes in, dad goes in, whoever, that it's always the same, that they know what to expect, and that creates secure attachment, comfort, promotes great development, and will help them to adjust much faster, and it's ultimately so much fairer and kinder for them too. So to recap, make the decision and be on board together. Set up the environment, have the environment ready and right for your little one to safely go into their own new sleep space. Choose the approach that's right for your child, that you're confident with, you're clear on how it works, and you can consistently stick to. that's choosing it, then you're going to implement that. That's your fourth step. You're going to implement that approach with utter consistency every single time. Your four steps to moving from co-sleeping into sleep training. Thanks so much for watching. If you've liked anything about this episode, then please leave a comment below and hit subscribe for more episodes like this. If any of your friends would benefit from seeing this video, then please do share it with them using the hashtag #TheSleepNanny. And we look forward to seeing you again real soon.